We're discussing today the systolic and diastolic blood pressure readings. Let's see which of the two numbers is more important. The upper number, or the first reading, is the systolic blood pressure. The lower number is the diastolic blood pressure. Blood pressure monitor usually shows a third number, heart rate. Systolic blood pressure indicates how much pressure your blood is exerting against your artery walls when the heart beats. The diastolic blood pressure indicates how much pressure your blood is exerting against your artery walls while the heart is resting between beats. Usually, doctors give more attention to systolic blood pressure, the first number, because it's a major risk factor for cardiovascular disease. In most people, systolic blood pressure rises with age due to the increasing stiffness of large arteries, long-term buildup of plaque, and increased incidence of cardiovascular disease. Other potential reasons for high systolic blood pressure may be overactive thyroid, diabetes, or heart valve problems. If you are over 50 and you have a high systolic number, you might be at a greater risk of having serious cardiovascular problems, such as having a heart attack, a stroke, or a severe pain in the chest. High systolic blood pressure can even result in chronic kidney disease. These are all very serious medical conditions. Now, let's look at the risks of having a diastolic blood pressure out of normal range. Elevated diastolic pressure could weaken the main artery of our body, known as aorta. Also, there are risks associated with the diastolic blood pressure being below the normal range. Our coronary arteries are fed during the diastolic phase. This is a phase between the heartbeats. If someone has a low diastolic pressure, it means they have a low coronary artery pressure, and that means their heart is going to lack blood and oxygen. This kind of chronic, low-level condition may weaken the heart over time and potentially lead to heart failure. Also, diastolic blood pressure below 60 makes many people feel uncomfortable. A lot of older people with low diastolic pressures get tired or dizzy and have frequent falls. So, which number is more important? Both numbers are equally important. This is evident from the specific risk associated with each number, so both readings should be taken seriously. That is what American Heart Association says about it. In one recent study, cardiovascular risks rose with each unit increase in systolic pressure above 140 by about 18% on average. Meanwhile, each increase in diastolic blood pressure above 90 was tied to a 6% increase in heart rate disease and stroke risk. One more thing to take into account. Just because you are taking blood pressure medication does not necessarily mean that you should stop taking blood pressure readings. According to the American Heart Association, you should agree with your doctor what time during the day you should take blood pressure readings and keep doing them regularly. Take 2-3 readings 1 minute apart and average the numbers to minimize mistakes. Make a note of your results to discuss them later with your doctor. Here are the blood pressure categories as suggested by the American Heart Association. One more thing. Heart rate and blood pressure do not necessarily increase at the same rate. Even though your heart rate is beating more times a minute, healthy blood vessels dilate to allow more blood to flow through more easily. Moderate workouts are great for cardiovascular health. When you exercise, your heart rate speeds up so more blood can reach your muscles. It may be possible for your heart rate to double safely, while your blood pressure may respond by only increasing a modest amount. This means that it makes sense to monitor regularly both blood pressure and heart rate numbers. Here is the age table from the American Heart Association, which with target heart rates for moderate exercise and also maximum heart rates. Moderate exercise, healthy eating, and stress management are primary ways of reducing blood pressure naturally. When it comes to anxiety and stress management, breathing exercises, meditation, and acupressure can help you to lower blood pressure in just a few minutes. Check out these workouts on our YouTube channel or download our Breath Now app to perform these workouts offline. Please share this video with anyone who may need it. Please subscribe to our channel. Stay healthy and have a great day.